Thank you. second lieutenant. The subtitle says an ROTC officer whose military bearing does not quite conceal his real nature. The second movement, the Calliope, then says, with delusions of grandeur, the organ of the Big Top attempts a romantic waltz. The third movement, which is a lot of fun and brings me to my weapon of the evening, the gramophone, an early lo-fi phonograph, plays broken record variations on a 1920 dance theme. And the final movement, pinwheel, says this contraption leaves the players breathless. I have to agree. Jan Bach is an American composer with a wonderful sense of humor. He was also quite a fine horn player, which may be a reason that this part is so fun.
Thank you. you like mysteries, then you'll love this piece. This piece is all about the mysteries of its inception, of the different themes that Elgar presents in really unusual ways. And if you're familiar with the Enigma variations, you know that Elgar liked to hide little puzzles in his music. This piece doesn't quite have that same specific puzzle. In the Enigma variations, he hides a theme and says, this is a common theme, go and find it. And scholars have been spending decades trying to find that theme. This doesn't have any puzzles like that, but there's a real mystery as to what the program of the piece might be. Unlike the piece you just heard, there aren't little program notes by the composer where he describes, this is what I was thinking, this is the program of this piece. All we know is basically where he wrote it, because he puts at the end the name of the location that he wrote it. But knowing that Elgar likes to have secret programs, scholars have spent a lot of energy trying to figure out what the program is here. And there are a number of theories, including the specific, a mysterious forest that is right by where this place was where he composed the piece, with haunted trees. Another theory involves a novel by a contemporaneous British author called Short Stories that this piece might be based on. And they've gone and traced his library record to see if he, in fact, checked out this book from the library at the same time as he wrote the piece. That was a real hook for me, actually, because there's this sense of detective work and figuring out what this piece is about. It's not a conventional work. It's not played too often. And one of the reasons is that the presentation of the themes is not kind of a conventional Germanic way. And if you try to think of it compared to Brahms or Schumann or other big piano quintets, it ends up leading you down the wrong path. But when I found out that there was this sense that it might be connected to a secret program and that different scholars were trying to piece that together, it kind of unlocked the piece for me. It's a really long piece, and so I encourage you to listen with open ears and a sense of trying to solve the mystery of the work. Don't try to listen for first theme, second theme, sonata form kinds of things, or even the interaction between the instruments, but just kind of let yourself be open to some very unusual ways that he treats the instruments and the different themes. So here's the very seldomly performed Elgar piano quintet.